So The Hunger Games, Hollywood needed a new big blockbuster franchise based on a popular book series. Harry Potter's done, Twilight's going to be done in November, and now we have The Hunger Games. And it's set in futuristic North America called Pan Am, which following a catastrophic war has been divided into 12 districts. Jennifer Lawrence, Oscar nominee for 2010's Winter's Bone, stars as Katniss Everdeen. She lives in the poorest district, number 12, with her younger sister Primrose and her mother. She also has a boyfriend named Gale, played by Liam Hemsworth. Each year, Pan Am conducts the Hunger Games, in which one boy and one girl from each district between the ages of 12 and 18 are chosen at random to compete in a fight to the death in an arena which is televised live across the nation. There are 24 contestants called tributes, and only one can come out alive. Primrose gets selected, but Katniss volunteers to take her place and be the female tribute. The male selected is PETA, Journey 2's Josh Hutcherson, who's anxious to fight but believes that he's not going to survive. Each of the tributes gets special training for a few weeks so they can be prepared for the competition. Woody Harrelson is quite good in the role of Haymitch, the District 12 mentor. He does what he can to try to prepare Katniss and PETA for the Hunger Games.
You know, the popularity for this one has been all over the place. It's got an interesting premise, but does it work as a movie?
I think the first hour or so is very good. I mean, we meet a lot of interesting and unique characters and really get involved with what's going on, especially with Jennifer Lawrence's character. But the setup, unfortunately, is better than the payoff. I mean, The Hunger Games quickly turns into a deadly version of the TV show Survivor with a little Truman Show and American Idol thrown in. But it does work as social commentary, dealing with the issues of America's obsession with reality TV and celebrity. I mean, when this film turns into an action film, a total action film, though, it just loses its appeal and momentum.
Big cast. How are the performances?
They're pretty solid all the way around. I think Jennifer Lawrence is great here. Not an Oscar-worthy role, but definitely a star-making role. As I mentioned before, Harrelson is quite good. I think this is some of Hutcherson's best work. You've also got Elizabeth Banks, Donald Sutherland, and Stanley Tucci, who's great in every single movie he's in.
Got a lot of teens waiting for this one to come out and standing in lines to see it, and it's about teens fighting to death.
Right.
Is it appropriate?
Well, The Hunger Games is rated PG-13 for a lot of intense action violence, but this is as close to an R as you can get without it being R. I mean, there's so much graphic violence, teens fighting and killing other teens, and as you see it on the screen complete with blood. This is not for young kids, even those who may have read the book series.
If I follow you right, you might be on the fence about this one. What's your grade?
On the official LCJ report card, The Hunger Games gets a B-. I think it's going to do huge at the box office for the weekend, $135 million. Which will break the record for an opening for a non-sequel movie. I just wish the second half was as good as the first half.